Yes, let us continue, dear children. I don't know why it got cut. So we saw that NaOH is the limiting agent, okay? Because whichever is present in lesser quantity, that will act as limiting agent. This is 0.04, this is 0.05, which is less, this is less, okay? Whichever is less, that is the limiting agent, okay? Now, for the formation of 1 mole of water, this many kilojoule of energy is released. Now, how many moles are combining? 0.04 moles, okay? So, here what we saw, 1 mole of this and 1 mole of this is giving you 1 mole of water. So, if this is 0.04, this will also be 0.04, right? So, 57.1 into 0.04, you will get this many kilojoule of energy released, okay? Then the next question is, 200 cubic centimeter of 0.2 molar H2SO4 is mixed with 400 cubic centimeter of 0.5 molar KOH. Okay, now let us see that. Now H2SO4 plus 2 KOH will give you K2SO4 plus 2H2O. This is the balance equation. 1 mole of H2SO4 is reacting with 2 moles of KOH to produce 2 moles of water. Okay, so if I take KOH as 1 mole, then H2SO4 would be half a mole, is it not? If this is 1:2, and if I take this as 1, this would be half, right? Okay, so basic concept you have to understand, right? Okay, now what we are going to do, we are going to we have to calculate the volume of sulfuric acid and KOH that is given in the form of number of moles, okay? So, 200 upon 1000 into 0.2, 400 upon 1000 into 0.5, KOH is 0.5 molar, yes. So, this you will get 0.04 moles and KOH you are getting 0.2 moles, okay? So, 0.04 moles of sulfuric acid you are getting. Now, each mole is giving you 2 moles of H plus ions, is it not? 1 mole of sulfuric acid is giving you 2 moles of H plus ions. So, 0.04 moles will give you 0.08 moles of H plus ions. Right? Be very clear with this. Now, on the other side, you are having KOH 0.2 moles only. Okay? So, this is 0.08 and this is 0.2. Now, in this case, which is the limiting agent, which is less? Out of 0.08 and 0.2, obviously 0.08 is less. So, whichever is less, that is the limiting agent. So, H2SO4 is the limiting agent. Right? Okay. Now, 1 mole of this, 1 mole of this will give you 57.1 kilojoule. Okay? So, here, this is going to react 0.08 and this is also 0.08. 0.08 kis mein se? 0.2 mein se. Okay, that means 0.12 moles of KOH will remain unreacted. Remember that. So, if this is 1, this is 1, this is also 1. So, if this is 0.8, if this is also 0.08, then this is also 0.08. So, what you have to do? You have to find out now 0.08 moles ke corresponding. The amount of energy released is 0.08 into 57.1. You will get this many kilojoule of energy. Is that clear? So, these type of numericals also you have to be familiar. Okay? Then, this is another question where heat of combustion of butane is given, -2658 kilojoule per mole. When butane is undergoing combustion, it is releasing 2658 kilojoule of energy. So, when you show it as delta H, you will show it with a negative sign, just to show that the reaction is exothermic. What is its calorific value? Now, what is calorific value? Calorific value is nothing but the amount of energy released per gram of the substance. Okay? This is kilojoule per mole. So, 1 mole of butane is giving you 2658 kilojoule of energy. Now, what is 1 mole of butane? That is 58 gram. So, 58 gram is releasing this much of energy. So, 1 gram will release how much? So, this upon 58 will give you the answer. So, what is the calorific value of butane? It is 45.8 kilojoule per gram. Is that clear? Calorific value is energy released per gram. Right? Heat of combustion is energy released per mole. Right. Then I gave you one other question regarding this ethane, today's homework. 2C graphite plus 3H2 gives you ethane. I asked you to write, frame the equation, I told you. You frame the equation, okay? Then C graphite to C gas, H2 to 2H gas. And according to the necessity, you have to multiply the equation and you will get C2H6 giving you C graphite plus 3H2. Why? You have reversed this equation. Why you have reversed this equation? Because you want C2H6 on the reactant side. Okay. So you reversed it. Then your C graphite has gone to the product side. Okay. And in this equation, C graphite is on the reactant side. So let it be on the reactant side so that it will be eliminated while adding. Okay, Hess law says that it is heat of summation, is it not? So you have to sum up everything. So this will be multiplied by 2, this will be multiplied by 3, and you will rewrite the equation like this. After rewriting, you will find C graphite cancelled, 3 hydrogen getting cancelled. You will get the equation C2H6 giving you 2CG plus 6HG. Right? Now, based on the values that are given, you will add up everything and you are getting 2825.77. Exactly, whatever values are given, that way you are simply adding everything. If there is any negative sign, then accordingly you have to add. So this much, what is this? This is delta HR. Delta H of the reaction. Okay. What is that delta H of the reaction? Delta H of the reaction is bond energy of reactant minus product. Okay. And what is there in the reactant? Reactant may C2H6. Is it not? You are having C2H6 on the reactant side. And what is this made up of? This is made up of 1 CC bond and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 CH bonds and 1 CC bond is there. Okay. So that's what I have written. 6 CH bonds and 1 CC bond. And on the product side, you are having both carbon and hydrogen in the form of gas. So it is 0. It's taken as 0. Is it not? So when you substitute the values, you will get 329.77 as CC bond energy. That's it.